Yeah, apparently, you know, if I just use the section view command, you know, it defaults to, you know, normal to your view, I suppose. But, you know, if you highlight a plane and then select it, it'll default to whatever plane you highlight. So you can see the, you know, what's going on here.
Also should mean use sweeps constructed with simple geometry. If you have to use a loft, that should mean that the feature makes a transition from one profile to a different shape profile. It also should mean that there are no commands or combinations of commands that can create the feature. Simple is always better, so if the features on your parts can be constructed using simple geometry and commands, you should use them.
Okay, I just wanted you to hear that. So apparently this thing probably could have been constructed with a sweep of like an ellipse or something, following a guide curve instead of as a loft. So, because apparently that creates harder to machine or manufacture geometry or something. Not sure. I mean, he didn't actually go through and do it, so I don't know if we would have ended up with some different result or whatever. But anyway, you know, when trying to rotate parts, you know how it gets all skewed. Just, you know, be sure to use the Alt middle mouse button, you know, if you want to straighten your parts, since it doesn't do it automatically. Still wonder if there's a setting in there that makes it work like it's supposed to or not, but I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna do something called a 3D sketch here. Now you can see it's a little different and the cursor's different. You know, right now it's selected the XY plane, so I'm gonna start by drawing. And you can see our inference there pop up. So I'm going to draw a 5-inch line, and then I'm going to draw another 5-inch line along this axis. Now for this line, I'm just going to freehand it, but I want it to be at a 45-degree angle. So, but I'm going to define it later, so I'll leave that undefined. This one, on the other hand, I want to be, you know, essentially parallel to that other one, the 15 inches. But now, you know, like I said, I'm still constrained to the XY plane, but if I hit my tab, you know, now I'm in the YZ plane. Hit my tab again, I'm in the ZX plane. So, you know, you can kind of see what I'm talking about. So, at any rate, I'm going to draw it along the YZ plane here, 15 inches. Okay, and then I'll stop out. But let me go in here, and I want to take a dimension between these two lines and set it to 5 inches. Okay, but I also want to take this and set it to 135 degrees, which I should have done to begin with. So, anyway, this dimension became detached for some reason. I don't know if that's a problem or not. But at any rate, you know, these dimensions, you know, I still drew, you know, you notice there's not a plane reference cursor, but it's drawing them in the appropriate plane. But the thing is this is still not defined. Okay, but anyway, we got to add a little reference plane on here. So I'm going to click that little plane button. Okay, and it defaults down to there, but you got to select reference geometry. So like, if these two lines want to define a little work plane. So, you just have to click enter, and if you select off of it, boy, I can't see that. Yeah, man, I couldn't see that at all. Yeah, I can't see it. I mean, it's still there. Huh. I'm going to have to figure that out. But at any rate, I want to add a sketch relation to it, so I can add a plane, an on-plane reference, and now that fully defines the line. So, but yeah, I mean that motherfucker disappears. I mean, if I didn't, or if me dragging my cursor over and seeing that thing light up, I wouldn't know it was there. I don't think there's anywhere to select it. That's unsettling. I think the problem is view, you go down to 3D sketch, and the sketch plane's not highlighted. So there we go. Now I can see it. So, pretty crazy for that not to be on by default, you know what I mean? Anyway, if you look down here, you'll see the sketch is fully defined since I did that. But yeah, as you can see, it was a 3D sketch, so. But I'm going to add some more shit to it now. I'll use my Alt key to get it to rotate. Alt, middle, mouse button to get it to rotate. Okay, I added a little fillet command here. But now, we can exit the sketch. There's no exit sketch up there, but wow. But anyway, highlight the top plane, throw a sketch, put a 1-inch circle on it,
and then select the path. Now apply the operation.
Alright, just made a pipe.
Looking into the Hyundai Elantra.